just take Nigeria, you know, to enlighten the people of our various community to already know about the struggling and the distress African black men and women are going through at the process of coming to Europe for a greener pasture, you know. So it's an amazing exhibition here in Switzerland today again about the same topic, silent cry, the journey for survival. We're still trying to make the Swiss people to see and to know what it takes for an African man or an African woman, what it actually means or what it takes to come to Europe through the Sahara and the Mediterranean Sea. So, we give thanks and praise to the Most High that it was successful again in Switzerland. We all say a very big thank you to our guests who came. We weren't really expecting the people who really came, you know. They were amazing people, lovely, and we appreciate them so much for coming, you know. And they got inspired with the paintings, with what they saw. And I hope the message will go viral and go across the world so that people will know what it means and what it takes for a black man to come to Europe through the Sahara and Mediterranean Sea. Thank you. Let's bless up and enjoy, you know?
Yeah, surrounded by history and it's documented here. Godfrey is a legend, a maverick of what it takes to survive and being a witness to the catastrophic attempts to try and get through the Sahara, to get through the sea, right? And so I was asked to participate by making a picture, and so I would just like to say that I did contribute to one of these pictures, and this is it here, and it's kind of based on Italy, and it's kind of like one of those stories that came up, one of those tragedies where the Italians had a problem with their ship because everybody leaned over on one side and the whole thing capsized. And that's, you know, that's what kind of sticks out in my memory anyway. And being included in this gallery is a very honorable moment for me, because I do have a soft touch for Africa. I'm really interested in the artifacts, the ebony woods, and I'd like to introduce you to a little corner that I participated in, and I'll try and bring you through. This is one of the largest statues here. This is from Blau, the Senefault tribe in Ivory Coast. The dimples on it kind of remind me of like a hieroglyph, you know, the image is like 3D almost. And I work for a carver, a famous carver, Terry Edgar in Islington, who had a 17th century artifacts in his four house apartment in Islington in London, where Madonna made a movie in, I'm sure it was a video for one of her songs, because he had I Captured the Castle is also a movie that was made in his house. So being surrounded by carvers I know that it takes almost a genius, almost, to get the symmetric levels perfect. So we have like, we have the whole body is in the image of a human. Everything, like a human was standing. Everything's in proportion and symmetric. I'd like to add this guy here too. He's got one of the most symmetric faces. It's like it's being poured, but these are heavy woods. And this one here, this actually sinks in water. It's like a bust from maybe an Ethiopian princess. This here has lots of history on the internet. It was casted in 1940, 1950. It's from the Congo and it's like for medicinal purposes. And these are two women on each side. And the lizards on top are protecting the contents inside. The contents inside is like a medicinal herb. And then you leave it in, and then after a while you take it out and you consume it, and you're healed. And these figures here, I'll just finish with these two figures here. These two figures are so old that the wood is almost petrified. And it's like you can see the ebony, some of the ebony has defects in it, and that's why there was a protection on the plant, on the tree. No longer can you import or export this ebony. But in our grandfather's days, they were bringing them home for souvenirs. And these are from like roughly 1950, but the tree itself, it seems to be like because it's actually broke and you can see it won't glue back together again. It's like concrete. And you can see the particular type of reaction with time with the wood. But it's kind of quite amazing that all the woods the Africans have. This is ebony, this is some kind of mahogany. This is a light wood. And this is the most heaviest one here. This looks like it's a kind of like an ebony as well. But this one is like hardwood. It's also a tree that reacts like ebony, very expensive, and very durable. Thank you very much.
Okay, Graham, thanks for having you.
Thank you,
on our gallery, Swiss Integration and Solution. It was really nice to have you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's an honor.